In this video tutorial, we do 10 runs with the line following and the Lego education spine frame. The goal is to demonstrate how consistent this line following program could be. Let's see. Let's see how the program works. We start. We use the phone to mark the location where the robot arrived. And in this way, we can see how consistent it is on the next run. Here it is, first run. This is where the robot is. This is where the robot arrives. Second run. We try to start from the same position. At least the starting location and position should be consistent. We follow the line, no problem there. But there is kind of like a 1 centimeter difference there, and it's bugging us. Why is it happening? Why do we follow the line correctly, but at the same time we cannot reach the phone consistently? And you can see that, so this was consistent with the second run, but not with the first run. So first run is different than second and third. Something's going on here, and we should think really hard. Let's check this run and where the robot will arrive. Yep, almost there. So what we are seeing is that the robot is kind of like consistent. It arrives almost at the same place, but not exactly. And there is a half an inch or a centimeter difference there. And we're kind of wondering why. The reason why this happens is because of the timer. In this program, as we described in the previous tutorial, we are using the timer. And when we are using the timer, we are setting the timer for 10 seconds. Okay, move for 10 seconds. And 10 seconds, it's a different time every time. And I know it sounds bizarre and it sounds strange, but what's happening is that the wheels, they slip in different ways. The battery has a different charge. Something on the mat could reduce or increase the friction. There are a lot of things that could happen in this small run. And even the motors are not perfect and the brake is not perfect. A lot of errors could happen. And we say follow for 10 seconds, but these 10 seconds get us to a different place every time. What we should think about, and we are doing it in some of the next tutorials, is not to use a timer, but to use a different event that could tell us, so now is the time for you to stop. So timer is a good tool, but timer, it gets you to about half an inch or a centimeter difference every time. And if it is okay for you, if the attachment could handle this difference, then please go ahead, use the timer. But if you need a little bit more precise robot, then we should think about a second event. The robot is reliable, the program is reliable, the algorithm is quite simple, following the line is quite simple, it is easy to do it both for rookie and experienced teams. And the only consideration here is think about the timer with the initial position of where do we start the robot in the base. That's it. 10 runs. See you in the next tutorial.